science. The lesson which we are studying today is lesson 6, administrative system and architecture during the medieval age. In the previous videos we have already studied about the introduction paragraph, about the architecture, administrative system and also the literature part of our lesson. These all the things which we are studying are related to the medieval age, or you can also say Rajput age. Now, in this session, we are going to learn a small story about Mahmud Ghazni. It is also called Mohammad Ghazni or Mahmud Ghazni, whatever you call. Here is a story. Before starting, in this chapter, we have already studied about Rajput age. Rajput age is very well known, very much famous for its valor and sacrifice. मतलब राजपूत एज बहुत bravery के लिए and sacrifice के लिए तो जाना जाता ही है. But it is also very famous for the architecture, as we have learned. Among that, the architecture of the temples was noteworthy, बहुत special था. We all know. But एक और चीज की वजह से भी, because of one more thing, it was also special because of the invasion. ओके मतलब उसपे बहुत सारे रूलर्स, फॉरेन रूलर्स, दे कम एंड दे ट्राई टू रूल ऑन दैट, ट्राई टू कैप्चर दैट टेम्पल, लूटने की कोशिश करते थे. दैट इज व्हाई देयर इज अ स्टोरी ऑफ मोहम्मद गजनी, महमूद गजनी. ही वाज सुल्तान ऑफ गजना. गजना यू कैन से अफगानिस्तान, प्रेजेंट अफगानिस्तान में देयर वाज अ प्लेस गजना, वहां के ये सुल्तान थे. एंड ही अटैक्ड ऑल इंडिया so many times between 1000 CE and 1075 CE. इस time period में not for single time or two times, बहुत सारी बार इन्होंने attack किया था India पे. And in that, छोटी सी story दी है. First of all, why he was attacking? बहुत बार क्यों हमले करते थे? Because we all know कि attack करते रहते थे वो, और कभी कभी fail होते थे, कभी कभी success होते थे. But in spite of facing so much problems during the attacks, इतनी सारी problems face करने के बाद भी he continued to plunder India. India को लूटने की कोशिश करते रहे. India से सारी जितनी भी gold वगैरह everything he want to capture, चुराने की कोशिश करते रहे. बहुत ही full force के साथ अपनी army को ready करके, तैयार करके, बहुत ही force के साथ वो attack करते रहते बहुत बार. Once there was attack on Somnath temple in Gujarat, we all know that. So at that time, King Bhimdev Solanki, he was ruling on Gujarat. In this battle, Bhimdev Solanki was ruling on Gujarat. Mahmud Ghazni wanted to capture all the wealth which is in the Somnath temple of Gujarat. In Gujarat there is a famous temple Somnath, जिसके बारे में हमने previous video में पढ़ा है. So when there was this battle running on, common people from Saurashtra and Gujarat also joined King Bhimdev Solanki. They also tried to protect their Somnath temple from the clutches of Mahmud Ghazni. In this battle, at last, these people lost and Mahmud Ghazni won. For the first time, Somnath temple was captured, and after that, गुजरात पे भी थोड़ा सा कब्जा मोहम्मद गजनी का हो गया था. सो दिस वॉज द स्मॉल स्टोरी. मूविंग टू अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. नाउ द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज चेंज ऑफ पावर एट दिल्ली. हाउ द पावर वॉज ट्रांसफर्ड, जो भी आप कहो. सो दिल्ली, इन दिल्ली देयर वॉज अ चेंज ऑफ पावर. हाउ इट वॉज डन, लेट्स सी. वी ऑल नो अबाउट मोहम्मद गजनी. Now what happens, Mohammad Ghazni is dead. After the demise of Mohammad Ghazni, in the Ghazna, there was a chaos. There were people discussing that who will sit on the throne or what will happen. This is the thing of Ghazna, Afghanistan we are talking about. So, isliye, there was a discussion going on, and in this discussion, Shahabuddin Ghori came and he established a strong rule on Ghazna. Ghazna, unhone apna rule jamaya, and after the strong rule, he decided to attack India. India pe attack karne ki koshish ki. Why he decided to attack India? He was not in the mood to loot India. India ko lootne ke liye nahi, but he wanted to establish rule. अपना रूल जमाना चाहता था इंडिया पे. दैट इज व्हाई ही डिसाइडेड टू अटैक ऑन इंडिया. इनिशियली ही वाजंट सक्सेसफुल इन द स्टार्टिंग. ही वाज नॉट सक्सेसफुल. ही लॉस्ट द बैटल. ही अटैक्ड ऑन द आंदिलवाड़ा पार्ट इन गुजरात. इट इज अ प्लेस इन गुजरात. वहां पे ही वाज हैविंग अ बैटल विद क्वीन नायका देवी. सो ही got defeated in this battle and he was not able to let it go ki main ab ye ladai haar chuka. So after 12 years usne kuch attack nahi kiya tha India pe. But after 12 years he decided to attack on India second time. Dusri baar usne decide kiya ki he will attack on India. Now what will happen when on the second time जो उसने attack किया, एक story याद रखिएगा. Nayaka Devi was the queen of Anilwara Patan. He that means Shahabuddin Ghori and Nayaka Devi, they were having fight and Shahabuddin was defeated. Shahabuddin was not able to forget this thing that he got defeated from a lady. So after 12 years, second time he attacked on India, and at that time Prithviraj Chauhan was ruling on India. It means Prithviraj Chauhan was having the throne of Delhi. Delhi pe Prithviraj Chauhan ka raj tha. Prithviraj fought bravely. Prithviraj ne bahut bravely Shahabuddin Ghori se fight kiya without the support of other Rajput kings. Remember this thing. Prithviraj Chauhan when he was fighting, koi support mein nahi aaya. किसी और का सपोर्ट लिए बिना ही फॉर ब्रेवली. बट एज ही वॉज नॉट हैविंग एनीवन सपोर्ट ही लॉस्ट द बैटल. हु लॉस्ट द बैटल? पृथ्वीराज चौहान ने हार गया बैटल. ही लॉस्ट द बैटल. ही गॉट डिफीटेड फ्रॉम मोहम्मद गौरी. एंड विद दिस मोहम्मद शाहबुद्दीन गौरी, यू कैन से शाहबुद्दीन गौरी एस्टैब्लिश्ड हिज रूल इन ऑन दिल्ली. ओके, शाहबुद्दीन गौरी को मोहम्मद गौरी को बोला जाता था. ओके, सो शाहबुद्दीन गौरी लॉस्ट, सॉरी, ही एस्टैब्लिश्ड हिज रूल ऑन दिल्ली. दिल्ली पे उसने अपना कब्जा जमाया. एंड विद द डिफीट ऑफ पृथ्वीराज चौहान व्हाट इज द रिजल्ट? रिजल्ट क्या मिला? यस, राजपूत एज केम टू एन एंड. अब पृथ्वीराज चौहान एज ही हैज लॉस्ट एंड that is why he is regarded as the last Rajput king of our India. Here the Rajput king, Rajput age ends and the new king started ruling. Shahabuddin Ghori came. After Shahabuddin Ghori died, there was a new dynasty which started. Yes, slave dynasty, as you can see here. Now how it slave dynasty started, uske baare mein padhte hain. First of all, the founder of the slave dynasty is Qutbuddin Aibak. Qutbuddin Aibak is the founder of slave dynasty. Qutbuddin Aibak was also a commander of Shahabuddin Ghori. Means Qutbuddin Aibak aur koi nahi tha, Shahabuddin Ghori ka ek commander tha. When Shahabuddin Ghori died, to wo gaddi pe baith gaya, matlab usne raja ki kursi le li. And with this slave dynasty ke sare new kings came forward and they started ruling on Delhi, on India, and the Rajput age is pay of this time pe it is coming to an end and new kings are coming. So this was all about our topic, change of power at Delhi. Now let's have a quick review about what we have learnt in this chapter. First, we have learnt about the administrative system during the Rajput age. In this, we have learnt that how the kingship was transferred. It was not compulsory that the elder son of the king would become the next king. Also, we have learnt about the administrative system in the villages. We have learnt about the sarpanch and how there was the Gram Panchayat and Gram Sabha. Next, we have learnt about the literature. What kind of books were there in the Rajput age or in the medieval age, you can say. For example, we have taken the book named Kumarpal Charita, Siddhim Shabdanushasan, etc. We have learnt about many books, and the books were composed in many languages, that means Sanskrit, Prakrit, Telugu, Tamil, Kannada, etc. Next, we have learnt about the different architecture. In this, we have learnt about the
different temples, that the construction of the temple during the medieval age was very noteworthy. So we have learnt about different sun temples and the famous temples which were there in the medieval age.
Here we are also at the end of this chapter. Here we have completed this lesson. I hope that you have understood all the topics. Go through the videos once again and watch it. We will meet in the next session. Till then, stay safe, stay home. Thank you and have a nice day.